Alright, so this is a new video, and in this video we are going to make a new bottle design. And as you can see, we have used this reference for our design. And to be honest, I have made this as a reference, as you can see, and you can easily put here in the front. And if you want to make the opacity maybe larger, we can stick for 0.65, and the size will be 5, but we can scale it later. So if you want to make it real size now, from now, you can go to add a circle, and this circle will have an radius or full diameter of around 0.9. We can go here and put the radius of 0.09 like this. And after that, we can scale all our geometry up to the circle. So I will scale around 0.4 and make it here to be 0. And let's see what we have. Maybe going there in the direction, and let's see what we have. So I think this may be better visualization, but we will go to be 0.2 or 0.135. Alright, so we will stick for 0.132, and after that, maybe going to enable the screen cast case. So I will search for add-ons, and after that I will enable the cast case to be better to see what we have typed. Anyway, let's get started. I will start from the outer shape, and maybe starting from a large circle, and as usual, the radius we will become here. And you may notice that our reference isn't centered correctly, but we can fix it here. And I will extrude sometimes in this direction and extrude to this area. You can see that we have a pattern here, and this pattern can be made from shaders later, and we can extrude to match or to match this reference. So I will extrude in the Z axis and scale shift Z. Let's extrude another time, and I will scale like this. And we will stop here. So maybe moving in this direction, and extrude another time in this view. Let's go back and scale down, and let's scale it like this. Anyway, we have this one. Maybe adding two loop cuts here and scale down like this. All right, let's see what we have there. We have now some areas, so some details here. We will extrude in the Z and scale. I will scale like this and extrude another time in the Z axis, and let's scale down and fill this area. We can make edge here, another edges to define the shape much better. So we have now the outer shape. All this will be an chrome or metal, and let's make now the lid. The lid isn't so hard, but we can duplicate this one and separate by selection, and then I will extrude in the Z axis. and move to this distance and scale down up to this area. Alright, and the lid can be made by extruding scale shift Z and to extrude to this area. And to be honest, we have here four pieces, so we can make something. We can move to this, and I will select these four. So let's select all these vertices and scale in Y by 0 and scale on X like this. Let's see what we have here. Scale in Y by 0 and maybe I will delete these vertices and let's extrude in the y direction until we reach this distance, which is here. And we can now bridge this edge loop. And after that, we can extrude in the z axis up to this distance and fill all these faces in the same direction. Let's fill and like this the other one. Alright, and if we see the reference, we haven't any reference more than this, but we can define the shape. So we can define that we have this one, 2. So I will go here to be honest, this lid has some detail in the top, but we can go for searching and find some reference that match our design. So we are now here in this view, and I think that I have found some close reference for our design. This lid we will replicate here, but with our design. So let's go back and send the item here. Now maybe we have to make this better like this, and after that then let's select all the surfaces and click Ctrl N T to recalculate normals. And we can start from a circle. This circle will have around maybe 16 vertices. And we can start to go back here and let's rotate to this area, and I will go to scale in Y around 1.7, scale in Y around 1.8, and after that we can go to delete these vertices and I will isolate the item and fill faces sometimes like this. And let's add. And after that, we can extrude. Let's move here. And I will extrude in the Z axis. And we can select, we are now in the bottom view, and I will select all these and insert to this distance. And let's go to select some vertices and maybe extruding in this direction. We have to select. I will go to select all these surfaces and extrude and scale in this direction. All right. If we come here, we can see that our lid not the same. We have made a replication. We can add the smooth shading for this one. And in the modifiers, we will say that we have a subdivision surface of level 2. And let's go to add this. We have here this curve. It can be defined by selecting the mouse here, and in the proportional editing we can move like this. We are here, and we want to make the shape much closer to the reference. To make this, we can. The better you or the lower velocities you have, you will make it much easier. And maybe enabling this for now. And I will make it a smooth shading also. And in the top part, extrude Z around 0.9 and extrude Z until you reach this maybe extruding to this one and extrude another time and fill. And if we have added some subdivision surface, you will see that you have, and this must be more than this. All right. So personally, I don't like the surface, which is didn't make any sense for us, and it isn't flat anymore. So we can select all the surface. Make sure that you haven't not selected this one. And you can scale in Z by 0 and make it go in this direction. Let's see what happens. It's not better. So in the next part, we will start to add materials for our design.